We're here walking for climate change awareness in New Hampshire. And Colin, how's it going?
It's going really well. I'm really excited about this. I think that we're really making a difference here.
It's all about personal responsibility. Everybody has to do their part, right, Colin?
Absolutely. Personal responsibility is the key.
We can't be lazy. We can't just let other people do the work for us. We really have to each take a part in helping the climate. And if we don't, each of us, do our part, there's not a prayer, right, Colin?
That's right. It's all about doing our part, taking small steps, but all of our small steps adding up. If it's changing our light bulbs or offsetting our electricity or, you know, buying a hybrid, walking instead of driving, taking shorter showers, all those steps add up.
Are we technically carpooling?
I don't know if this is carpooling. This is it's along the same lines.
We might be able to get there faster, like take a different lane or something for this.
Yeah, seriously, that's a really good idea.
You be able to tell if a presidential candidate coming to New Hampshire is serious about the environment?
This is actually a non-political issue. We are only in New Hampshire because there's a lot of attention here. So we're just hoping that this message just reaches, you know, the entire nation, because New Hampshire is basically the megaphone for the nation right now.
What inspired you to walk?
It's for the earth.
That we need to save the planet, make sure that it's safe for the next generation.
And what's that called?
That's called, this is all the people marching for real global warming solutions.
Have you walked the whole way?
I have. I walked for 5 days.
Have you showered at all?
No, can you smell it?
Yes, you have not showered in 5 days.
I'm one of the awesome 25 kids that helped put all of this together. It's been inspiring, it's been impactful, and hopefully it's only going to continue to grow.
Welcome to the final rally. Great to see so many awesome people here.
Job one is get rid of new coal. And if you think there's not the money to make this happen, just look at the banner from our friends at Budget Priorities over there. One day of the war in Iraq costs enough money to put 1 million homes in the renewable energy business. 1 year of the war in Iraq, and that takes care of all the households in this country. There's only one way to make this change happen in time, and it's not working one by one. It's incredibly important that we do that stuff in our homes. It's incredibly important that we screw in the new light bulb. But you know, the people in New Hampshire in last year's elections showed us an even better way, which is to screw in a new congressman.
I'm Congressman Paul Hodes. I just came in from the floor of the House of Representatives, where we passed an energy bill last night. We just shifted our priorities from subsidizing big oil and big gas to renewable and alternative energy sources in a big way. And it's just the beginning. We're going to go further.
We've got a long ways to go. We've got to build more and more energy. We need bigger and more powerful movement. We need it in the next year or two, because that's the time frame we've got.
Three things any American could do to best help the planet.
One would be organize politically. Two would be organized politically. And three also would be organized politically. And once you've done that, then make sure that all the light bulbs in your house are, you know, compact fluorescents.
What would you like to hear the candidates talking about around this issue right now?
Somebody needs to start showing a real vision of how much we need to do and how we're going to do it.
I'm supporting Hillary for president.
I really believe in what Obama is doing for America.
Dennis Kucinich would be the best candidate to be president on all the issues, including the environmental issues.
She can hit the ground running and rebuild our alliances around the world, which I think is going to be essential in solving the global warming crisis.
Not only does he have like a 95% approval rating from the Sierra Club, but I see him as someone that can really listen to different viewpoints and bring together a consensus to move forward.
He's the only one who sees things as systems and understands how one thing you do will influence other things. And he will be great on the environment, and he'll be great on everything else.
People kept asking me, who are you supporting for president? Who's your candidate in the primaries? And I know that that's the question that everybody around New Hampshire asks themselves all the time, and it's an important question, but it's not the most important question right now. The most important question is, will whoever occupies the White House face a country that demands that they change? Remember only this, a movement needs to keep moving. We'll see you all down the road.